Talofalava, welcome to Tagata Pasifika, Nisa Yandra, Fakalofalahiatu.
Talofalava, Maloni, thank you for joining us on the show today. Tonga's Queen Mother celebrates 90 years in style.
She's a very special woman. She's turning 90 today, and we're just really happy to be able to celebrate that for her.
John Pulu breaks out his woolies for Mangere's Park Up for the Homeless.
We actually got a roof over our head, and there are people out there that don't have that.
And he's helping others realise their dreams, but it could have been oh so different for the brown butterbean.
God was really watching over me because I should be dead or in jail.
Very interesting story. Looking forward to that one. But first, here's your Pacific News, brought to you by Indira Stewart.
Thanks, Marama and Sena Polava. An inexcusable lapse in judgment. That's how the Samoa Observer newspaper described its decision to print a controversial story on a suicide victim on its front page last Sunday. Editor-in-chief Ngatoa Itele Savea Sano Malifa said they made a mistake when they published a photo showing the body of 20-year-old transgender woman Janine Tuivaiki. The story sparked widespread outrage and criticism, with many expressing their disgust and shock.
I was incensed. Very angry. That should not have been on the front page of the major newspaper in Samoa.
What Samoa Observer did was wrong at all levels.
A clear violation of, you know, media guidelines in Samoa, especially with reference to the newly endorsed media code of practice.
The editor also apologised to the wider LGBT community and has since visited Janine's family. And thanks to the Coconut for that story. To Auckland now, where the issue of suicide was also very much on the minds of those who marched on the waterfront recently. Those who've lost loved ones to suicide came from all over the city to walk the 5Ks from St Heliers to Okahu Bay. Hope Walk New Zealand founder Joseph Fafil says the initiative came from wanting to give those affected a voice.
We want to break the silence, we want to break the stigma and the shame around suicide and also mental health. It's actually giving everyone the opportunity to actually have a voice and walk, you know, on behalf of loved ones who have gone and also those who are struggling with mental illness. So it's giving the opportunity to say, hey, you're not by yourself.
Growing up as islanders, you don't talk about stuff like this. Like, it's real hard, especially us, like, coming from a background, you know. It's just something you don't talk about.
Pasifika and Māori are the highest amongst our current suicide stats, Tongan youth being the highest amongst the Pasifika group and Māori highest overall. A comprehensive study on the flora of the Cook Islands was launched in Christchurch recently, written by retired New Zealand botanist Bill Sykes. The book is a 20-year labour of love. At Landcare Research HQ in Lincoln, Sykes and his family were joined by members of the science and Cook Islands community. High Commissioner Tere Moana Yala says the work is a valuable resource for the community.
You know that we have very little resources that's documented, so one more addition into what we already have can only enhance and make it better for our people.
Sykes travelled to the Cooks many times from the mid-1970s to collect samples. He dedicated the book to Cook Islander who encouraged him to write it, the late Tony Utanga.
To do it, to try it at least, and to make sure I went to as many places as possible and to meet people I hadn't met before who could be helpful. So I owed everything to Tony.
Unlike previous publications, the book looks at flora on all 15 of the Cook Islands. The Heart Foundation hopes a new cookbook, which puts a healthy twist on traditional Pacific food, will prove a hit in the community. Launched at the Ōtara Town Centre last week, the book features some old favourites given a healthy makeover. Dietitian Mafi Funaki Tahifote says the book is meant for families to cook together.
Heart disease is the biggest killer of New Zealanders, and Pacific, of course, is part of that. So we're inspired to, through food, to get our families healthier so that they live longer with their families. From Niue is the Takihi, we've got Boka from the Cook Islands, Lu from Tonga, Balusami from Samoa, and then we've got curry from Fiji.
I like it. It's very easy to cook it and it didn't cost power, but easy, cheaper in the shop to go and get it.
Healthier versions of our traditional fatty island foods, and it's just a really good way of cooking it, I guess.
You can also download the book for free on the Heart Foundation website, www.heartfoundation.org.nz. And finally, the best amateur mixed martial arts fighters from around the globe will gather in Las Vegas in 2 weeks' time to compete in the IMMAF World Championships in the lead-up to the UFC 200. Among the fighters preparing to take on the world in the heavyweight division is Cook Islander Cameron Tukua. Training out of the Auckland MMA gym under coach Hamish Robertson, Tukua's preparation was disrupted by a bout of sickness.
Nullified my training, so now I'm back, I'm feeling 100% and I'm working harder to get fitter, stronger in the last 2 weeks I've got left. With my preparation, all you can do is how you step into the cage on that day, is that's you there, it's just you and him in the ring.
Tukua won't be the only New Zealand-based fighter there. Tongan Gina Kola will also be competing in the women's division. If both fighters do well, the next step is the UFC. And that's Pacific News. Back to you, Marama and Sena Folava.
Thanks, Indira. Hey, I couldn't help notice, but you got a different last name. Some news there?
No longer Moala?
Yes, God blessed me with a wonderful man who put a ring on it.
Oh, no way.
I know, but don't be fooled by the Palangi name. I'm still a coconut.
Awesome stuff. Congratulations, Indira. Thanks.